The Philippine Internal Revenue Bureau exceeds its collection target for April. The agency says it collected over 336 billion pesos. The University of the Philippines says while government borrowing is normal to fund projects, this has to be managed. He says more borrowings could lead to higher taxes. Punong Bayan was reacting to the Philippines' April debt figure, which stood at nearly 14 trillion pesos last month.
Sino bang nagbabayad niyan? Kung hindi yung current na henerasyon o tayo, ay maaring yung mga anak o apo natin sa hinaharap.
Tama.
So, hindi maiwasan yan kasi alam nga namang utang ka lang ng utang, pwede namang gawin ng gobyerno na yung utang niya dati, yung pambayad niya doon, ay utangin din niya sa ngayon. So parang nagro-roll over, kumbaga, yung utang mo. Parang only utang na siya. No? Pwede naman yun, pero of course, at some point, sa ating kasaysayan ay dapat bayaran natin yung mga utang ngayon kasi hindi talaga siya sustainable. At mababayaran yun kapag ka minayaran siya ng mga susunod na mga henerasyon, pero ang problema, baka sila yung magbayad ng mga karagdagang buwis.
As for the Philippines, its factory activity posts a faster output growth in May. The S&P Global PMI went up to 52.2 from the 8th-month low of 51.4 in April. This means manufacturers reported faster delivery of needed raw materials, which helped them meet growing demand. S&P said there was strong demand last month, translating to more orders, especially from foreign markets. Some manufacturers also attracted new clients. RCBC Chief Economist Michael Ricafort says the improvement in the local manufacturing index may have to do with the easing in inflation, backed by the decline in oil prices, as well as increased economic activity during the summer season. The Philippine Central Bank is developing free online courses on personal finance. This will be done in partnership with the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, or TESDA, and BDO Foundation. The three signed the deal in a bid to boost the financial health of TESDA's 4 million learners of technical and vocational skills. The courses, which will be available in 2024, will cover financial planning, saving and budgeting, debt and investment management, digital finance, and consumer protection. The shareholders' vote that will approve Metro Pacific Investment's plan to delist from the local bourse has been pushed back. Explaining the development, the Pangilinan-led firm says the consortium that had initiated the voluntary delisting wanted a fairness opinion and valuation report for the tender offer be made available before its annual shareholders' meeting on June 6th. But since the report has yet to be finalized, MPI says it will approve the bidders' request to defer the vote and hold a special shareholders' meeting at a later date. The bidders consist of Metro Pacific Holdings, MIG Holdings Inc., GT Capital Holdings Inc., and MIT Pacific Infrastructure Holdings Corp. The decision to delist, announced in April, had sparked controversy, particularly around the tender offer price set at 4 pesos and 63 centavos. More local corporate stories. Semirara Mining and Power Corporation eyeing to make another trial shipment to Japan this month to reduce its dependency on Chinese market. The firm says it will export around 50,000 metric tons of coal to Shikoku Electric Power Corporation for its 700-megawatt power station. The company first made a trial shipment to Japan in January, selling some 78,000 metric tons of mid-grade coal to a utility firm. This came after Semirara saw a near 50% decrease in its coal shipment to China in the first quarter. For MREIT, it will acquire 7 office assets from its parent company, Mega World Corporation. The assets have a total gross leasable area of around 150,000 square meters. The properties that will be given to MREIT are in Taguig, Iloilo, and in Davao. These generated 1.2 billion pesos of rental income in 2022. And finally, a deal between INAEC Aviation Corporation and U.S. electric sea glider maker Regent. The Lopez-led company says the agreement with Regent will bring its sea gliders to the Philippines. Sea gliders are a new kind of vehicle that is a cross between a boat and a plane. They fly just above the water at high speed, but at a low cost. Regent says its sea gliders are all electric and zero emission. INAEC ordered 15 of those vehicles, which it will use mainly for tourism. Stocks in Asia kick off June higher with a bill to raise America's debt ceiling passed by the House of Representatives. The measure hurdled the Republican-led chamber with a vote of 314 to 117. The bill heads to the Senate, where Democrats hold a slim majority. As early as now, Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders says he will oppose the bill due to spending cuts that he says will make things harder for working families while giving it easy to the wealthiest in America. Lawmakers are racing against time to raise the borrowing limit days before the June 5 deadline set by the U.S. Treasury. Taking a look now at major stock indices in the region, we're seeing Hong Kong's Hang Seng recovering after approaching bear market territory in previous sessions. Japan's Nikkei 225 also up to return to the 31,000 mark. Bucking the trend, though, are the Chinese Shanghai Composite and the South Korean Kospi Index. Over in Europe, futures point to a higher open amid hopes the U.S. debt ceiling saga may finally be coming to a close. Stateside, we're seeing signs of a mixed open in Wall Street. The Dow is in the red, while the tech-heavy Nasdaq is unchanged. Trading resumes tonight, Manila time.